Hey, everybody. This is just going to be a quickie. I just want to give you an update on the updated news. Remember, I did a video about a week ago, maybe a little bit longer ago, about somebody going across the fence out in a preserve area and cutting down a bunch of trees because they wanted to improve the view. And nobody seemed to know nothing about nothing. Well, this has happened before, and I knew that this was going to turn into a fiasco because it did before. Hopefully, whoever is in control of all that, they learned a lesson from the first one. It turned into just a major problem. I ended up getting some money from an unknown source. I'll put it that way. They know who it was, but they won't say. An unknown source left a check so they wouldn't be prosecuted. And these people over here who around Lake Deaton over there that's cut that tree down, some other bush down, whatever, you can't do that. You can't go across the fence and as a preserve. And they take that serious. Well, they've been doing a lot of investigating up to this point. And now it's got down to where they're saying that the PWAC, which is our money, the residents' money from all over the villages, is going to have to pay for the remediation. In other words, to put that tree and stuff, another tree or whatever, back in there. And I have said on my other video that this was probably going to come down to this, and it's wrong. That, you know, I looked right at the camera and I said to whoever cut that down, I hope they take you to court. I hope you have to pay high dollar attorneys. I hope they fine you, put a lien on your house, whatever it takes to put that back in there, because there are certain people that come down here. They don't care about the rules. They don't care about their neighbors, and they don't care about you. And I know I'm sounding rough here, but I want to make my point clear that people in our area pay for other people's mistakes, and that's not the way to punish them people, because all it tells everybody else is, hey, it's okay just to go ahead and break the rules because they'll make everybody else pay anyway. That's like saying, well, it's okay to do something wrong because, well, I've got house insurance. The insurance will pay for that. Thieves say that all the time. Thieves. They say, well, I stole the guy's car, but it's probably no big deal because they had insurance. You can't use that as a reason to be an asshole. And yes, I'm talking to the people to cut the trees down. And they hired a company or somebody to cut them trees down. Probably some idiot in a pickup truck and a trailer that doesn't know about rules and doesn't care. All he cares about is how much money he can collect at that given time. Because to cut all them trees down, cut them in pieces, drag them through a yard, load them up on a trailer or whatever, and haul them out of here, all the neighbors had to know that. And the police know that, and they've been investigating. Well, here's a letter from a resident in Chitty Chatty. Chitty Chatty is a new village, so it's new. They're new residents. They don't know that probably a lot of this stuff goes on, even though I've been reporting this kind of thing for a long time. I get ridiculed about the news because I pick out all the bad stuff. Well, kind of I do, but I really don't. I'm just telling you what the news is. I'm just trying to tell you what's going on around here and how it works so you don't come down here thinking that everything's just hunky-dory when it's not. And these are some of the things that happens, and it's just not right. I don't think it's right. I've been arguing about these kinds of things, using our swimming pools as public restrooms for everybody, and they're not supposed to be that way. I've called John Rohan's office many times. I've emailed John Rohan's office many times. He's the head of the recreation department here. He can control that kind of thing. He can set it up where that kind of thing can be slowed way down. They just won't do it. His nose is up the developer's ass so far. He's turning brown. And I hope he gets upset with it. I hope he emails me. I'll get together with him. They want to have coffee, and I'll, in a rational way, I'll talk to them. I'll show them video of some things of what's going on at some of these rec centers that we're paying for that nobody else is, but the people that aren't paying anything are the ones dirtying them up and playing games in there, and they just shouldn't be there. Did you see some kind of heaven movie? Real quick, did you see the snippet where the bum guy living in the van was taking a shower at a swimming pool and washing soap off his face and into the pool, whatever? How'd he get in there? He's not a resident. See what I'm saying? That's the kind of thing that goes on here, and that movie even showed it. So I hope the developer takes any of that serious, but he won't. Okay, here's the start of their rant. It says homeowners should have to pay for damage. That's the title of what was on the news thing. It says, to the editor, this is a letter to the editor. The Lake Deaton property owners and the contractor who illegally removed a large swath of tree adjacent to their properties. First of all, we don't know it was a contractor that done that. It was just somebody they hired to come in and do it. And it could have been anybody, anybody. I'm telling you, these guys running around in a pickup truck and a trailer and all kinds of whack materials on the back, they could just stop one of them guys. Hey, do you know anybody that would cut them trees down for us? Oh yeah, my brother-in-law will do that. That's what happens. They should be held financially responsible to restore the area. The villagesnews.com article states the project-wide advisory committee will bear the cost to rehabilitate the area. However, this damage is not caused by Mother Nature or the natural aging of infrastructure that requires replacement. Why should other property owners through the PWAC be liable for the cost to repair the damage? Good question. I brought that up two or three times. I got no answer. This sends the wrong message. It says it's okay to damage village property. Others will pay to fix it. The responsible parties should have given a bill for remediation work. If they fail to comply in a timely manner, liens should be affixed to their properties. This is the only way to discourage others to do similar acts. 100% in agreement. Now, how do you get their people's in control here's attention? I don't know, because apparently these videos don't do it. And I know for facts, and I'm not going to say how I know, that the developer and the land company down there watches all these different YouTube channels here to see what's being said, what's being done. And I know they don't like some of the things that I say, but what I say is not wrong. They know that child molesters should not be moving in here some way, somehow. You know, you got them high dollar attorneys down there. Get them the hell out of here. They shouldn't be next door to a swimming pool where children play. I mean, what the hell's the matter with you? Anyway, I better get out of here before they send the cops after me. With that being said, raise hell. See you on the other side.